certainly live in interesting times, but whether or not that's a good thing, let's talk a bit more about these separatist movements in Europe. Jürgen Pfister joins us now. He was a longtime chief economist at Bayern LB, and he is certainly a keen observer of European economic developments. It's very good to have you here, and fittingly, you almost wear a kind of Scottish tie today here with us. Now, Mr. Pfister, we've observed that the British pound has come under a lot of pressure because of this Scottish independence referendum. What are financial markets so worried about?
Well, the main factor seems to be uncertainty. Nobody knows what the outcome of the referendum will be. And if there will be a yes vote, then of course there are very important open questions regarding the currency of Scotland, regarding its role in Europe, and regarding also its share in the government debt of the United Kingdom. And therefore, I think investors are a bit nervous.
From a Scottish point of view, could Scotland survive economically?
I would say yes. It's a small economy. It's only roughly 8% of GDP of the United Kingdom. But of course, it's a very wealthy region compared to the European average. And therefore, I think, yes, they can survive.
Now, you just mentioned only 8% of United Kingdom GDP. Now, if there is a yes vote, the United Kingdom would lose 32% of its land mass, not so much in GDP, but in terms of the wider economy, in terms of oil revenues, perhaps as well. I mean, what would it mean for Britain?
Well, of course, it would mean that this is a major structural change, although I think we should also take into account that the revenues from oil and gas are declining for many years now. And of course, this may be over in 10, 15 years. So it's not a lasting source of wealth for Scotland.
And a reduced Britain, what would it mean for Europe? I mean, a lot of people say, rightly so, that Scotland so far stood to a large extent for the Social Democrats, for Labour in the UK government. If Scotland was to leave, then England would become more conservative, perhaps more Eurosceptic?
Yes, I'm afraid that if there will be a referendum after the election in 2015 on the membership of the United Kingdom in the European Union, without Scotland, there will be a no vote. And this, of course, would be a major damage both for the UK and for the partners on the continent.
What repercussions would it have exactly?
Well, in terms of economic policy, of course, I would say the UK is the only major ally for Germany in terms of open market policies, liberal economic policies, and not those policies which are favoured by, say, Italy, Spain and France.
Well, there's at least another referendum before this particular question, whether the UK should leave Europe or the European Union or not. There are separatist movements also in Europe, Belgium and Spain. Now, they'll surely keep a close eye on what happens in Scotland. And then what?
Well, of course, a positive vote in Scotland would certainly give them some support in their own efforts to leave their country. But I think the legal situation, the constitutional situation is different in all these countries. And therefore, I think it's still an open question that whether this would have been a lasting impact on these questions in Spain and Belgium.
Now, it seems somehow that the separatist movement, some of them aren't that new, but there is a very strong movement right now that we can observe. At the same time, we've got the Eurozone debt crisis, which has not yet been completely solved. We've got geopolitical tension. We've seen a rise of Eurosceptic parties across the EU. What's gone wrong in Europe, and how can it be solved?
Well, I think it's in some case, of course, this is the result of, say, a very quiet and wealthy situation in the end, because in times of need and despair, we would hardly think about separating a country. And therefore, I think these developments are closely associated with the long-term success of Europe.
Okay. Well, Jürgen Pfister, thank you very much for joining us today.